Hello and welcome to Prudent Media News. The top stories this are: existing national highway to be expanded, no separate super express highway for Goa. Galgibagh and Talpona bridges get green signal. Legalizing DDO is not a priority, preference to Galgibagh Talpon bridges, says South Goa MP Francisco Sardina. Goa University suspects Dr. Aureliano Fernandez on the charges of sexual harassment to girl students. Opposition leader Manohar Parrikar demands sacking of Panji Commissioner Melvin Vaz. Avenas and Lalush Alemao Memorial Football Tournament begins on Sunday. And big hopes all around as AFC Vision India Summit proposes steps to boost Goan football. Now the news in detail. Goa may not have a separate super express highway but would expand the existing national highway to 4-lane and 6-lane. PWD Minister Churchill Alemao claims that the central government has agreed to this proposal. Union Minister Kamal Nath has also given green signal to Galgibagh and Talpona bridges as well as a parallel Zuari bridge.
PWD Minister Churchill Alemao believes that proposed plan of super express highway in Goa will demolish around 1,200 houses. Churchill has brought this issue to the notice of Union Minister Kamal Nath. Alemao also claimed that Kamal Nath has accepted the proposal of expanding the existing national highway to 4 and 6 lane.
Today, this was the highway committee sent it by Gulbar Smith. These people done the alignment. 1,200 houses and buildings are going. So I said nobody is going to accept this and nobody is going to allow us. So this is the reason I said you must understand the difficulties of the Goans and you must go pursue the past this highway you wanted. Then he said it's fine.
Churchill Alemao also claimed that because of his efforts only, Kamal Nath has given green signal to Galgibagh and Talpon bridges along with the parallel Zuari bridge.
I told him, if there is some problem, I told him these three bridges you must take the separate package. One is Zuari, Talpona and Galgibagh. I told them Talpona and Galgibagh bridge. I told him when he was in the house in 1990, I am the only man who fought for that. The two bridges and that time the sanction. And our local government was done the survey and we done the land division, both the bridges in 25 years now. Zuari bridge is very important because another 6 years is a guarantee for that. And before that, we have to start that another bridge. Otherwise, there is no any parallel line, nothing is there to go south, north. There is no any alternative. So he took very keen interest and said, I am going to take up this issue.
Churchill also met Defence Minister A.K. Anthony in Delhi and requested him to allow the devotees to visit church at Asdeep Island.
I told them that the people who are there, about mostly Catholics, are not getting an opportunity to go for the feast or mass. So please give their permission for us.
A reporter from Madgaon, Ramesh Naik Raut.
Legalizing DDO is not my priority. This is announced by none other than South Goa MP Francisco Sardina. On the contrary, he has assured to lay foundation stones of both long pending bridges of Galgibagh and Talpona by next year.
It was his first press conference after Sardina got elected as a South Goa MP. When media person asked him when he would move the bill in the parliament to legalize DDO, he got furious.
That it is not my priority at all. I have never gone for this, but I'm in favor because we are there to representing people, what people want. Some people are against, they say, Sardin is being sent only to do this. So please highlight that you people ask me and then I reply because I'm in favor, I have to do this. अरे फकाणेशी तरी कोण पिशी आहे ते म्हणताय सार्दीन वत फकत बिलू करपाक बोलांचे सार्दीन बोलू रे.
Sardina had to face lots of music during elections campaign for neglecting major issues of the people and giving priority to Dhiryo Bill. But now he has clarified the matter. For him, all three bridges are on his priority list. The bridges on Zuari, Galjibagh and Tarpan rivers, also because they are part of the Golden Quadrilateral project.
I'll make sure that by 2010, the foundation stones are laid for these bridges. As the alignment is already fixed.
All these three bridges?
Three I will try, but then at least two for sure.
Zuari?
No.
Galjibagh
and Talpanna and Zuari also.
Yet another matter of concern is that Karnataka has almost completed the work of diverting waters of River Madai. We call it River Mandavi when it reaches Panji. Sardina now plans to raise the issue at the coming budget session. Sardina wants a special package to build tourism infrastructure in Goa. Though he does not agree with PWD Minister Churchill Alema on the issue of Mopa Airport, he is with Churchill on the issue of 6-lane highway. We should have 4-lane highways wherever it is not possible to have 6-lane. The South Goa MP has also taken serious note of neglecting Goa for its performance in terms of getting central assistance as per the Gadgil Mukherjee formula. The former chief minister has thus once again raised an old demand, give special initiative to Goa for its best performance.
And I requested them to have two formulae. One is the normal formula which they are following, and another formula for those who have already achieved those indicators in the form of incentives, so that others are motivated.
Our senior reporter from Panji, Rakesh Kanolkar, with video journalist Shreya Kurgaonkar.
Dr. Aurelian Fernandez, head of the Department of Political Science at Goa University, is finally suspended. The Prevention of Sexual Harassment Committee has found him guilty of sexual harassment. While suspending him, the Executive Council has also decided to appoint an inquiry officer to probe further into the allegation.
On Saturday, the Executive Council meeting of Goa University discussed the inquiry report submitted by the Prevention of Sexual Harassment Committee. Dr. Aureliano had charges of trying to sexually harass girl students. According to the committee, the students were indeed facing sexual harassment.
So the Executive Council had asked the Prevention of Sexual Harassment Committee to examine the complaints which it had received from some students regarding sexual harassment. The committee has already submitted its report. The report is presented to the Executive Council. The Executive Council has accepted the report, and the conclusions of the committee, Prevention of Sexual Harassment Committee, that some acts on the part of the concerned faculty do amount to an act of sexual harassment.
Besides Vice Chancellor Dilip Devbakar and the Registrar, the Executive Council meeting was also attended by Advocate Ramakant Kalap and Datta Damodar Naik. Dr. Sangodkar also told us that the Executive Council Committee had decided to suspend the faculty.
Considering this